Hi, I'm going to show you JSTOR's interactive research tool. The research tool uses generative AI and other advanced technologies to help you expand and deepen your research with JSTOR. The tool helps you more quickly assess whether a text is relevant to your research by highlighting key points and arguments, as well as explaining its connection to your search terms. It uses only content on JSTOR and appears on the item page for journal articles, book chapters, and research reports. To access the research tool, you need to be 1. Linked to your institution, and 2. Logged into your personal JSTOR account. To check your link with your institution, look at the banner at the top of any page on JSTOR. If the banner reads, "Have library access? Log in through your library," you should click on the login link in the banner. Then, search for your institution and log in with your institutional credentials. If it says, "Access provided by," you are already linked to your institution. For example, my screen indicates that I have access provided by JSTOR. Now, check for your personal JSTOR account. After the question button, in the top right corner, if you see the register and login buttons, you will need to log in or register for your personal JSTOR account. Making an account is free and will ensure seamless access no matter where you are logging in from, and it is required to use the JSTOR interactive research tool. If you are logged into your personal JSTOR account, you should see your name or email instead of the buttons. After you are linked to your institution and logged in, you are ready to use the research tool. I'll show you what that looks like in the rest of this video. So I am going to start a search for something I am interested in, like the filmmaker Agnes Varda, and I'll pick an article that looks relevant. On the article item page, on a desktop computer, the tool window will be adjacent to the document. When I first open my item page, the tool will automatically explain to me how my search term relates to the document that I clicked on. At any time, you can hide the tool and return to the standard item page view by using the on-off toggle button at the top of the research tool window. You can learn more about the text as a whole by choosing one of the prompts provided by the research tool or by supplying your own. The first supplied prompt, "What is this text about?" will tell me the text's key points and arguments. If the document has an included abstract, the tool will show you that abstract. Otherwise, it will generate an overview. Show related content suggests items in JSTOR that contain similarities in text. Recommended topics suggest key concepts that are relevant to the text. This can help jumpstart additional research by helping you narrow down your topic or providing ideas for further exploration. If you click on any of the topics, you will start a new JSTOR search. You can also ask your own question by typing your question in the chat box. Try asking the tool about specific topics related to your interests, like if I want to know about a specific Agnes Varda film, The Gleaners and I. You can use natural language and you don't need to word your request in the form of a question. The numbers that appear after the answer are the tool citing its sources, so it's showing you where in the article it got that information. I can hover on that number to see a preview of the text that the answer comes from, and I can click on it to see the text highlighted in the document viewer. You can also ask it to show you names and themes, which can help further your research. For example, ask what other scholars are mentioned in the text, and I'll get a summary of not only who is mentioned, but in what context. Then I could use this list to further my research by looking up the items that the scholars wrote. Or ask about the themes in Agnes Varda's work, and I will get a summary of themes that are mentioned in the text, which can be useful for refining my research topic. Other examples of questions to ask the tool include, what is the article's central argument? Or you can try something like, does the article mention other filmmakers? As we see here, you will find some limitations to the research tool as the tool will only provide answers based on the content of the item itself. It does not pull content from the rest of JSTOR or other websites. For another example, if the text does not explicitly state, the tool will not be able to confirm whether an article is peer-reviewed. If you have a specific section that you are interested in, you can also have the tool find related content or tell you about just that section. Try highlighting the text in the document, and then at the top of the text, choose Find Related Content or What is this selection about? And that will provide an overview of just that section. To dig into a selection, the highlighted text needs to be more than a paragraph so that it has enough information to condense. Once you have finished evaluating an item with the research tool, you might want to keep a record of your interaction. You can download your conversation history by choosing the three-dot overflow menu after the question text box and choose Download as PDF or as HTML. You can also select Cite Research Tool, which will give you auto-generated citations for the tool itself. You can also cite a specific response from the tool. Note that citation methods for AI tools are still evolving, so you should follow whatever guidelines are available to you from your institution or discipline. For the best results, cite or download your conversation with the tool before leaving the item page, since the tool only displays your current conversation for that item for up to 3 hours. So to wrap up, that is the JSTOR Interactive Research Tool. For more information on how the tool is powered and JSTOR's approach to generative AI, check out our frequently asked questions, which are linked in the video description. We are really interested in hearing how this enables your research, so please let us know. You can provide feedback via the form linked below the research tool or using the thumbs up and down buttons.